So please pay no attention to the fact that some of the board's cut off. And let's position that. Sure. That's as good as it's gonna get. Sorry. Okay, I'm gonna accept. And wish him good luck. All right, Bishop F4. This is not a Trompowski. This is kind of leaning toward playing a London system. And against a lot of these systems where black moves the or white moves the bishop out early, I tend to play like my queen to B6 or to A5 and throw in C5 and have a field day with it. Against a Trompowski, I'd play like he's Trompowski being bishop to g5, I'd play knight to e4. So what do I do here? I could try to play this like a peer. Or I could throw in c5 like I normally do. What do I normally play against Bishop F4? Well, usually I see Knight F3 first. So already on move 2, he's got me thinking. Good exercise. I don't want to. Well, okay. Is my bishop going to go to G7 or to E7 or somewhere else? I don't know. Definitely got me thinking here. Well, normally I play c5, but here he could just play d5 and run past it. He's aiming to play a London with okay. Oh, let me close that other window. He's aiming to play a London. Okay, I'm trying to justify my thoughts aloud. I shouldn't be doing that while I'm thinking. At least to just me being confused. C5 is what I normally play here. It's been a long time since I've played it. I am very confused as to what's going on, but at the same time, I'm a bit excited for what might come next. Also, I think I've successfully taken him out of book. Not that that was my goal. My goal is to just get my pieces onto good squares and develop and. Well, I guess my goal is to try to confuse my opponent a bit or present challenges for him. But that's not saying that I want to play systems which are gonna be fundamentally flawed either. Right. Now, B2 is somewhat loose here. If I play queen b6, got to play something like b3. At the same time, I'm toying with the idea of playing e6 here. Then he plays d6. That's no good. I'm concerned about the possibility of him lining up his pieces on this long diagonal and exchanging bishops. Should I consider playing g6 and bishop g7? Oh dear, am I playing some kind of Blumenfeld gambit? If I choose to play that way, it would be. Well, no, because he's still got. He can't play d6, though, can he? He might be able to play d6. If I'm reckless. So. Oh, but wait. If I induce b3, he's got all kinds of holes on that diagonal. And the more pawns he puts on light squares, the less places his light squared bishop has to go. And queen to b6 develops a piece and puts some pressure across the sixth rank. So let's play this. I mean, I've played this only in blitz. And I've had positive experiences with it. But mainly, the reason I've only played this in blitz is, well, twofold. One, over the board against opponents that I know and I can outfox and I know how to beat them. I don't play this sort of thing. Yeah, over the board, I'd play much, much crazier non-classical moves, just because I enjoy the adventure of the chess game, and it takes me all kinds of, well, to crazy positions you would never see in a sane opening. Oh, and the second reason I don't get to play this very much in longer games is because I don't find people who are willing to play these moves like bishop f4 and then pawn to d5. These things are kind of principled. Many players would, well, bishop f4 is kind of rare, and on occasions where I've played c5, they've either protected the d pawn or they choose to take my c pawn. That's why I've never seen this position before. At least in a long game. Possible I might have seen this in some blitz games, although a move like d5 is uncommon. That pawn is almost overextended. I don't know. If white can successfully hold the pawn on d5 without having all kinds of holes all across his position, then yeah, d5 is a success. But if all the dynamic play that black has here causes problems for white, then d5 is likely where these problems started, where black is moving pieces and white is kind of forced to push pawns. All right, with that said, my stream has been up for about 15 minutes. Let's see, I have a modest audience here. Welcome to anybody who's watching. I'll try not to embarrass myself too much with my lack of knowledge here. Oh, and please. Oh, hang on.
Okay.
And yeah, if you want to discuss my game, feel free to go to AmazingGoid's chat. Or at least I know I'm not listening in on that chat. But yeah, please, in this environment, don't kibitz moves or ideas. As frustrating as that may be for some of you who want to better understand what's going on here, as do I'll say. I too want to know what's actually going on in this position from a theory point of view. Yeah, please hold your questions until the game is over. Yeah, that's also kind of what I'm thinking, Daru Daru. I think that as other games wrap up, it looks like my game would be doing some of the cleanup. And then one challenge I've had with previous streams is that after my game's finished, often it seems like there aren't other streams going on. And so if some people listening in my chat could give me pointers as to like good chess people to host after my stream is ending, please let me know. There have been tons of ladder games today. It's just happened that my games just didn't finish at the right times for me to host other people. Okay, knight to c3. This protects the d5 pawn. This takes the e4 square. Also completely appears to ignore my threat of queen takes b2. I am very confused. Now, normally, queen takes b2, taking a poisoned pawn, is kind of dangerous. Because your opponent is really well developed, and taking pawns accelerates his development. Oh, and I'm a greedy materialist who likes to take pawns. So I'm finding it very hard to resist snapping up the b2 pawn, even before calculating it. I'm going to pause here and actually think, because I don't think while I'm talking. Sorry. I'm going to be quiet for a minute. I'm finding it a bit difficult to be objective here. And that's just from my own lack of knowledge about these kinds of positions. In so many positions, I just play what I want to play, and it happens to be right. So, where is White's e pawn going? I assume it's going to e4. Well, the principled follow-up to what I did is just going on taking the pawn. Queen d2. After queen d2, I mean, somehow that's supposed to be the principled continuation because it follows the same plan as what I had hoped, what I was trying to do earlier. That doesn't mean the plan is any good. It just means that I'm sticking to my guns if I do that. If I play knight to h5, you probably play bishop g5. So ideas of playing like a check Benoni-like structure, those kinds of ideas aren't that great. White's plan here is simply to push e4 and then push e5. And unless I devise some counterplay, I'm kind of in trouble. After queen takes b2, queen d2, I need to have something to deal with White's threats. Oh, okay. So I kept getting drawn back to this move d6. And now I finally see a reason supporting it. That supposing he does play rook b1, and I do queen a3, and then he does knight b5. Queen a5, oh, that's also check, by the way. Queen a5 covers c7. My queen's not getting trapped at all. What am I thinking here? What am I so terrified of? I take b2, queen d2. Wait, no, he doesn't do queen d2. That would hang the rook. Oh my goodness. Oh, I've been sitting here for the better part of 10 minutes, thinking about queen takes b2, queen to d2, not seeing that that would hang the rook on a1. That little tactical nuance, the fact that queen b2 forks the knight and the rook, really changes the nature of what's going on here. So if I take b2, can't play queen d2 to defend the knight. Can't play rook to b1 immediately to evict the queen. You need to play something like bishop to d2, would allow him to follow up with moves which would attack me. So in short, I'm collecting this pawn, and he doesn't have immediate counterplay the way White normally would in many of these positions with a poisoned pawn. The reason for that is that it's challenging to defend the knight. Yeah, I'm sorry, knight to a4 does not work here either. Reason for that is that this is a triple fork, hitting the king, the knight, and the bishop. So c3 defends the knight, but the bishop drops here. Okay. Well then. That's a bit embarrassing.